Hello everyone. This lesson opens a section that brings together cryptographic mechanisms you have learned so far and shows how they're used in some real-world applications. As you already know, the main objectives of cryptography for information security are data integrity, confidentiality, authentication, and non-repudiation. In this lesson, you will learn how hybrid cryptography combines different types of cryptographic mechanisms for secure communication addressing each objective. This lesson will cover the toolset of hybrid cryptography, its communication model, list actions each participant should perform for secure communication, and list the main applications where hybrid cryptography is used. First of all, let's recap what you already have in a toolbox of cryptography. Hash functions, symmetric key, and public key cryptosystems are each refined to address specific cryptographic objectives. Hash functions can easily detect malicious and unintentional changes to the input. Like a human may not see a typo in these two messages, but their hash are different. Two different messages may only collide in their hash with a negligibly low probability. This makes them a tool for ensuring data integrity. This way you know that the message received will be the same message sent. Symmetric key cryptography is well suited for quickly and reliably encrypting messages of any size, this way providing confidentiality. Like this 3D model of a shuttle is quite big, but is encrypted in a fraction of a millisecond nonetheless. Confidentiality means that the message sent will only be read by the intended recipient, as long as they have the same key. One issue is that the secret key exchange should be organized by some other means. Public key cryptography eliminates the need for a secure channel for key exchange problem, by having a public key shared open in media and private key stored by the owner without sending it anywhere. It also provides for authentication and non-repudiation. If the receiver gets a message digitally signed with the sender's private key, then only this sender could have sent and signed the message. Here, signature verification detects the type a human operator may not have noticed, and the signature verifies true only for the correct message. Now, let's put it all together. Imagine that Alice at a space research program needs to share with Bob, a colleague in an office in another city, a classified spacecraft model specification. They do not have a secure physical channel at hand to exchange a symmetric key, and the model is too big and complicated to be split into chunks suitable for public key encryption. They would also like to be able to securely share any further findings with each other on a regular basis. A hybrid cryptosystem is an example of a common way that they, or rather the system's administrator, would set up a secure remote communication between them and other scientists. The communication process, scaled down to just two participants for simplicity, includes the following steps as shown in the diagram. Alice will utilize hash, as well as both secret key and public key cryptography, to create a digital envelope for Bob that will ensure that the spacecraft model will not be tampered with in transit, and no one else but Bob will be able to decrypt and look at it. Now you'll see how all of that is done step by step. First of all, each party should have a pair of public and private keys assigned. For the purposes of this lesson, we will limit ourselves to just two participants, the usual Alice and Bob, but this approach is scalable to as many as needed. In this particular example, you will generate RSA keys for Alice and Bob, but elliptic curves key pairs would have also been suitable. Alice will be the sender in this example. The sender needs to construct a digital envelope for the recipient. First, the sender generates a shared secret key at random. As an additional precaution, this key is usually used only for a short time, for one single communication session or a single message. In this case, the shared key is called a session key. If the session key is somehow broken, and the next session key is random and not related to the current key, only the current session will be compromised. This property is known as forward secrecy. A compromise of one session does not compromise past and future communications. The session key is then encrypted with the recipient's, that is Bob's, public key. The message, in our case the spacecraft model, is hashed and signed by the sender, that is Alice's private key. Additionally, the signature can also be encrypted with the session key, but we will not do that for this example. Next, the message is encrypted with the session key. Finally, Alice packages all of that into a digital envelope and sends it to Bob. The envelope should contain the recipient details, the session key for a symmetric cipher for the session, the data encrypted with the session key, the signature, and the signer, that is the sender, that is Alice. When Bob receives the envelope, the decryption and verification process also comprises of several steps. First, he decrypts the session key with his private key. Next, the message contacts are decrypted with the session key, and he gets back the spacecraft model. Finally, Bob checks if the data decrypted was indeed the data that was sent by Alice, so he verifies the signature on the envelope with the sender's public key. And he sees that it matches. The hash digest is also matched and checked inherently during signature verification. This approach can be scaled to more than one sender-recipient pair, including cases with more than one sender and/or recipient for each signed envelope. Practical implementations of hybrid crypto systems similar to the one described in this lesson are used in many applications, including hypertext transfer protocol secure, transfer layer security, and secure shell network communication protocols. Open standards specifying such crypto systems also include public key cryptography standards and pretty good privacy cryptographic message exchange formats. In the next lesson, you will learn another ingredient needed to ensure this hybrid communication will work seamlessly at scale.